Duke has had to rely on freshmen, and led by Brandon Ingram, the freshmen have accounted for 49% of the points, 40% of the rebounds. But Wake Forest also has a youth movement, but they have their double-double star in senior Devin Thomas, averaging 16 and 10. He's mobile, athletic, runs the floor. Thomas really presents multiple issues for Duke.
Thomas poured in 14 and 10 against Louisville on Sunday in the ACC opener for Wake Forest. Duke 1-0 in league play. It's back-to-back road games for the Blue Devils after a Saturday win against Boston College up in Chestnut Hill. Roger Ayers, Raymond Stiens, and Sean Hull, the triumvirate of officials here tonight. Plumlee at center circle along with Thomas, and the ball is up. And Grayson Allen corrals it for Duke. The Blue Devils in the black and blue, and the Demon Deacons in the black and old gold.
Wake Forest opens up in a man-to-man. Some key matchups right there, particularly when you look at a Matt Jones. People play him for a three-point shot, but he's developed the ability to put it on the floor.
Went right by Thomas for two, Jones averaging 15 points a game. Mike Krzyzewski in his 36th season, accounting for 46% of all Duke basketball wins and a winner of 62% of the ACC games his teams have played on the road.
When you see that 1,030 number next to his name, you just can't get your arms around 1,030 wins. My goodness.
It's a lot of basketball. Here's Crawford, the freshman, to Mitoglou in the corner. Noted three-point shooter. He's got it. Got to find him. 38% from deep.
And over the last six games, Mitoglou was shooting about 50%, 14 of 28, make that 15 of 29.
And Brandon Ingram has the answer.
Brandon Ingram, so skilled, so talented. You look at that length and that size, and you recognize he can play beyond the arc as well as inside on the block.
A three-level score to be certain for the Blue Devils. Foul on the perimeter, that's on the freshman Derek Thornton. Second year here for Danny Manning, former number one overall pick who spent 15 years in the NBA. Got very high praise from Rick Pitino after their Sunday game. Even though the Cardinals beat them, Rick Pitino said they're no longer rebuilding. They are there. Manning wasn't quite as quick to jump to that conclusion.
Well, he recognizes this team has some work to do and there's plenty of time in this season to shore up the defense. Make sure Cody Miller McIntyre gets back to his form.
And he takes the feed from Thomas and drops it in. Miller McIntyre, a big part of their team the last couple years, just 3 of 20 from the field over his last three games. Wake Forest takes it away, a 4-on-3 advantage. Miller McIntyre with the left hand has 4 straight for Wake Forest.
And Wake Forest hoping to get in transition as often as they can. They run an outstanding break, and when you get the big fellas running, particularly Devin Thomas, makes it very hard to stop.
Ingram lost his dribble, gets it back to Thornton. The freshman starting his fifth straight game for Mike Krzyzewski. Baseline pass taken away by Wilbekin. And it's Miller McIntyre leading the break. 17-footer, 6 straight for Miller McIntyre, the senior from North Carolina.
And Cody Miller McIntyre last year averaged 14 and a half points a game, led Wake Forest in scoring that year and the year before. He's had some difficulty coming back from injury, but he seems to be rounding into form.
2 for 2 from the free throw line extended for Brandon Ingram.
Boy, how do you stop that? Ingram, a 37% shooter from beyond the arc, but you can't challenge him with his length and his accuracy. He's just a tough matchup.
In practice yesterday, Danny Manning, as Randolph Childress led the walkthrough, pulled his team together and said, remember, he is Kevin Durant-like in the type of game that he plays, Brandon Ingram with the basketball.
Look at him bringing the ball up right now, starting to trigger the offense.
Thornton with the first miss.
One of Duke's biggest fears right now is getting into foul trouble. As we mentioned earlier, a thin front line, the injury to Emile Jefferson has really made it difficult. 7-man rotation, all it takes is one person to go down in foul trouble, and that puts a lot of pressure on Duke.
Miller McIntyre had a mismatch, and Ingram on his back came up empty, but Mittiglus has the offensive rebound. Ball knocked out of bounds, and it stays here.
You look at Wake Forest anticipating the penetration and the kicks, and right there are just really surrounding the ball handler, and in transition, just lightning quick.
Wilbekin wanted three. That came up well short, and it's into the hands of Ingram, who leads the break for Duke. Now for Thornton with the drop off, and Plumlee flushes it to Duke up 10-9.
Marshall Plumlee, make no mistake about it, he's in there to rebound and play defense, but he has scored in double figures. 12 points, 10 rebounds against Kentucky. Good hands and the ability to get himself open.
Now it's Allen on the breakaway, step for step with Wilbekin, and he gets rid of the defender. Duke with a three-point lead. Grayson Allen averaging a team-high 21 points a game and 4 assists.
Yeah, Wake Forest averaging about 14 turnovers per game. That's one of the things that becomes a issue for them as they go inside to Devin Thomas. If they're not in transition, they really need to get paint touches. Danny Manning told us today that's so important regardless of who they're playing, but especially important today is they're going to try to get that Duke front line into foul trouble.
Allen nearly lost it. He kicks it out for Ingram, whose three is off the mark.
As well as Brandon Ingram shoots it, you don't want to fall in love with the three right now. You want to start putting pressure on Wake Forest up front.
Mittiglus was under the basket, fouled by Jones. Duke will have to be careful with fouls tonight.
ESPN's exclusive.
Take a look at their response after the injury. They've been spectacular. And when you talk about Brandon Ingram, you can't forget Derek Thornton as well as Kennard. Luke Kennard has also been outstanding coming off the bench. And those three guys particularly have carried the load offensively. Certainly Grayson Allen has chipped in, averaging about 21 points a game. He's been outstanding as well.
Allen has got his scoring up 16 points a game from last year. The biggest jump in the league and the biggest improvement in ACC history from one year to the next. After the free throws from Mittiglus, Wake Forest up by one. Fifth time that the lead has changed hands here in the early going.
And you look at Wake Forest up defensively, trying to deny passes at the wing to start the offense. Look at this.
Spin move from Ingram, turned away by Thomas.
Tell you what, though, you've got to marvel at the athleticism. Brandon Ingram, spider-like in the way he can move.
You got contact in the lane. And that's on Devin Thomas, the offensive foul, his first.
When you take a look at Thomas with the move, putting it on, he definitely did. Nice job by Marshall Plumlee to hold his position. Tough call, maybe a little too strong by Devin Thomas trying to get to the basket.
Takes a lot to knock over 7 feet, 250 pounds, but he did it. Here's Kennard.
Well, again, it was excellent positioning by Plumlee.
Second time the drop-off has been there for Marshall Plumlee.
And if you take a look at Plumlee, both times he's been behind the basket, essentially out of sight of the defenders until the penetration is made, the defender commits, and then Plumlee makes himself available.
Cornelius Hudson, the sophomore guard from Dallas, or forward, I should say, from Dallas, is off the bench for Wake Forest. Loose ball, Plumlee's up to grab it. Allen goes away from the ball screen and scores outside the lane.
Well, there's no question about it. Duke has been a major beneficiary of this new rules emphasis, taking advantage of the freedom of movement emphasis. They've gotten to the free throw line more than anybody in the conference. Seventh in the nation in free throws made, 12th in the nation in free throws attempted, and certainly first in the ACC.
Mittiglus offensive rebound and a stick back for the Greek.
that's exactly what Wake has to do. They've got to continue to pound the glass on both ends. Take advantage of the thin front line the Duke has presented.
The Blue Devils right now basically playing six players, seven if you count Chase Jeter. And there's three more from Allen, shooting 39% from three. Second in scoring in the league, only behind North Carolina State's Cat Barber, their point guard.
And among players in the power conferences, his 20.6 points per game is the fourth highest scoring average. And he's just been outstanding offensively. Take a look at where Plumlee is behind the basket. Defenders don't account for him. See him down low, all of a sudden, Mittaglue says, uh-oh, there he is. And again, excellent job by penetrating. And then outstanding job by Plumlee in making himself available coming from behind the basket.
It's back-to-back games where it's tough for Mittaglue. If he gets stuck inside, it was Chinonu Onuwaku against Louisville. And here it's Plumlee for Duke. Hudson turns the corner. And Allen's got it for Duke. Hudson has not connected well from long range this year. Just 8 of 35 now. That's under 25%. Danny Manning said after their practice this afternoon, he's a guy who needs to be a glue guy. Get rebounds, play defense. You got a foul there as Ingram goes airborne. Number 14, Duke on the road, up by four.
Judge a conference by the strength of the teams in the second tier. And if that's any indication, my, we are going to have some conference play this year.
Brandon Ingram is at the line. The foul was on Mittaglue, the sophomore for Wake Forest. His first personal. And the native of Kinston, North Carolina, puts through his first free throw.
And 10 double-figure games over his last seven games. Get this, averaging 22 points and 8 rebounds. Shooting better than 50% from the field and about 45% from beyond the arc. And again, the freshman has assumed the responsibility and has been outstanding.
It's a big turnaround from the way he started his first five games. Shot 36% from the floor. To the bucket, and it goes for John Collins, helping to end a stretch where Wake had just one bucket over the last 4 minutes.
They're really getting a lot of use out of Brandon Ingram. Fadeaway jump shot, Collins fouls him. And Duke knows exactly on what side of the bread their butter is, because they keep giving Ingram all the touches he needs.
The question's going to be for Wake Forest, who's the right guy to try and stop Ingram? And there you see the differences over the first seven versus the last seven for Ingram, and his rise in scoring. Prominence was no problem, a top five recruit coming in, really has coincided with the departure of Jefferson, much to the happiness of Duke.
Yeah, and what Mike Krzyzewski has discovered, what a difficult match he is against opponents defensively. If you take a look, an outstanding jump shot there, right on time. You know, Hudson really working on that perimeter shot. But in the end, don't be surprised if you see Cody Miller-McIntyre guarding Ingram. Miller-McIntyre did an outstanding job against Ben Simmons in Wake Forest's win against LSU.
Miller-McIntyre out of bounds. Ball stays with the Demon Deacons.
Take a look at Cornelius Hudson. We talked about him struggling from beyond the arc, but he's not afraid. And that's the most important element. You're not afraid of the big time. Shooters have to keep shooting.
5 second count approaching. Hudson takes a timeout. 10:31 to go in the first. And Duke with a 24-20 lead. ESPN has two big college hoop games for you Saturday. One Eastern, the Big Ten. Bello Trimble leads number three Maryland in scoring right now.
And you take a look at their offensive numbers, you know, right in the bottom tier as they try to continue to improve. And again, a lot of that has to do with the fact that reliance on a freshman, Brian Crawford, who has really lived up to expectations. But more importantly, you know, aside from Devin Thomas, there guys like Cody Miller McIntyre have got to come and start playing the way they're accustomed to him playing, which he's demonstrated so far.
John Collins running the floor for Wake Forest. Back to a two-point game.
Miller McIntyre with those eyes. Excellent court vision, finding Collins on the run. And we talk about him getting back into form. It's not just the scoring.
And that's an easy foul for Sean Hull to call. That's the second on John Collins.
Again, this is what Wake wants to do. They want to get in transition. And Miller McIntyre weaves his way through the defenses and still has an eye on Collins. And he's feeling it right now. You can tell when a guy, after a couple of games under your belt, after you've missed a bunch of games as well as a bunch of practices in preseason, you finally start getting the rhythm back.
Broke his foot in October, missed the first 8 games, hasn't scored more than 10 since returning. Thornton on the kick out from Plumlee, got it.
I was gonna say, that time Mittaglou found Plumlee, who was behind the basket once again, but the kick out, no one to guard the wing shooter. That's a foul, it's gotta be.
Strength versus strength, foul one on Plumlee.
You take a look at the drive. Allen with the nice drop off, and Plumlee excellent with the pass to the perimeter.
And you know what, it wasn't even a good pass to set him up for a shot, but the defense had collapsed so far, he still had time to collect.
Yeah, I mean, he had the presence of mind to kick it back outside knowing that he didn't have the shot.
Kennard drives the lane and the natural lefty gets 2.
Duke with a little bit of fast breaking of their own. Excellent transition, and you mentioned Luke Kennard, a lefty. And lefties have such an outstanding advantage since everybody's so geared to play right-handers. You know, muscle memory prevents them many times, the defender, from guarding a lefty the way he should be guarded.
Miller McIntyre the miss. Devin Thomas is there to stick it back. Ingram across midcourt. Demon Deacon's out of position. Grayson Allen makes him pay. And in transition, Kennard step for step with Cornelius Hudson. And Kennard is called for his first. So Ingram, Thornton, Plumlee, Jones, and Kennard all have 1 foul for Duke. On the other side, Thomas and Mittaglou each with 1. And the freshman John Collins with 2.
And Wake Forest cannot get away from what their intended strategy should be, and that is getting the ball inside, going inside out against Duke. Duke has done it to them.
Mittaglou brought it low. Matt Jones was waiting for it and ripped it away. For 3. Strong rebound from Thomas. He can bring it up the floor. He gets it back down the lane and hit as he was going up.
And we talked about it at the beginning of the telecast. Devin Thomas is a guy who presents a lot of problems. Not only is he a strong rebounder, outstanding touch in the paint, as well as about 10, 12 feet out, but he can run the floor, he can bring it up.
Foul on Jones, his 2nd. Spent some time during shoot-around today talking with Wake Forest strength coach Ryan Horn, and he was talking about Thomas, how athletic he is, and they have all these metrics to track how the players perform and how they breathe and how they run. And he said that Devin Thomas, for being a big guy, 6'9", 225, runs 21 miles an hour at his peak speed. That's the 2nd fastest on the team. And there is Ryan Horn, the strength coach who came over from Tulsa with Danny Manning when they made the move 2 seasons ago.
Boy, Danny Manning's so proud of the revamped weight room, all state-of-the-art equipment and measurements. Try to keep his guys among the fittest in the ACC.
Foul on Wake. Luke Kennard, best free throw shooter in the league. Have the stripe when we return to the Joel.
Yeah. said.
Opportunities for everyone right here on the first play. You're going to take a look. You see Marshall Plumlee's going to step right under here beneath the basket. And they're going to find him off of the penetration. You take a look at Allen penetrates underneath the basket. Nobody accounts for him. Now Wake Forest decides to adjust. They account for Plumlee, but Plumlee is able to kick it back outside. And that adjustment works against Wake Forest. And it all is started by the ability to penetrate.
Kennard now 45 of 49, 92% at the free throw line this season, best in the league. And Len, I'll tell you what, you look at those two replays, probably one big difference between the two plays. The first, John Collins, a freshman, was in the middle of the 2-3. The second, you had Thomas, the senior, in the middle. Out of bounds off of Kennard. Wake Forest down by 8 with the basketball, 7:46. Left her in half number one. Duke has won 9 of the last 10 in this series. The 244th time that these two teams have squared off in basketball. A series that goes back to 1906. A Wake Forest win that first game. Thomas on Plumlee. A spin and a foul. That'll go on Matt Jones. Rather, Derek Thornton, beg your pardon, his second. Jones and Thornton now each with 2 for the Blue Devils. Thomas shooting 2, 58% for the native of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And the first is good. Demon Deacons, 5th time that they're playing a ranked team this year. I mean, one win in those first 4, and that was against Indiana. Lane violation there, coming off a game where Wake Forest was just 3 of 12 at the free throw line Sunday against Louisville. 5 of 6 tonight. Offensive rebound. Miller McIntyre swatted away by Ingram and his 7'3" wingspan.
Is there anything that young man can't do?
Haven't seen it right now. Allen with the reverse layup.
Too many easy shots the Wake Forest has given up as Duke is really executing to perfection. Remember, Wake is last in the conference in points allowed, last in field goal percentage defense, and we're obviously seeing why. They've got to really tighten up and shut down the paint.
Reaching foul on Plumlee, his second. That's where things become dangerous for Duke.
Take a look, once again, recognizing foul situation. And obviously, opportunities. Duke is going to put the ball on the floor and try to take advantage of the freedom of movement emphasis. Quick first step when they're even able to get to the basket or get to the free throw line.
Off back iron, and as Plumlee picks up his second foul, Chase Jeter, the freshman from Las Vegas out of Bishop Gorman High School, has come into the game. And this is about the extent of their rotation. 7 players with Kennard and Jeter off the bench. Allen fires, Jeter, a touch on it, and it is thrown right on his back and out of bounds. So Jeter has played in 6 straight games, but varying numbers of minutes. The last 3, 15, 9, and then 6 against Boston College. And Coach K told us this afternoon, for a younger big guy, the development and getting adapted to the college game much harder for a forward than it is for a guard. Crawford down the lane, and the follow from Thomas. Kennard pump fakes his way inside the arc, and a 2 for the freshman from Franklin, Ohio.
One thing about both these teams, they like this type of pace. The question is, once again, can Wake Forest shut the paint down?
Ingram hangs and delivers, count it, and a chance for a three-point play.
It's just tremendous anticipation, and then the ability really to just hold his body and draw the foul and still make the play.
All three for Ingram. 41-29 in favor of Duke. Thomas looking for the high-low. Not there. Thomas was double-teamed. Couldn't find the open man. From the wing, Watson with a three.
Rondell Watson really hasn't had an awful lot of time. 3 points, five assists against Louisville. But Wake Forest needs somebody to heat up inside to take the pressure off the guys down low. And just as importantly, they need to get some stops. As Duke, as I mentioned before, as efficient as you would expect them to be.
Here's Thomas inside on Jeter, bowls him over and is rejected by Ingram.
And we talk about the Duke efficiency. Remember, they're second in the nation behind Virginia in adjusted offense efficiency. And that means the amount of points they score per 100 possessions.
A number that probably took a little bit of a dip for Virginia on Monday with the high number of turnovers they had against the Hokies.
Yeah, you're right about that. You're actually there, weren't you? Witness.
They doubled their season average of 8. Thomas hops down the lane, and even with Plumlee back into the game, Thomas has his way, making it a 7-point game with 4.5 to go in the first half.
I think Thomas was happy to see Plumlee in the game. Plumlee not as mobile, not able to guard him off the bounce when he's on the perimeter. But this is where the problem for Wake Forest lies, the inability to keep guys out of the paint. An outstanding drive there by Luke Kennard. Duke just keeps pushing the envelope.
Watson back for Thomas down the lane through three defenders, scores.
I tell you what, the senior is taking it upon himself. He's putting his team on his shoulders to stay within striking distance.
Jones has Kennard. He steps through. It's too strong. Watson leading a 5-on-3. Taking it himself. Swatted away by Allen. And a third chance goes Miller McIntyre.
Sputtering on offense until they put it in his hand. Quick first step off the bounce here. Once again at the top. No one able to get in front of him and stop his progress to the basket. And once again, coming off the screen, he's the outlet and he's the guy that makes stuff happen. It's again, his ability to get to the basket with that quick first step.
Kennard from the edge. He misses, and the ball into the hands of Miller McIntyre. Thomas has position. They clear out for the senior. He turns, and with the right hand, gets two more. 15 for Thomas.
And that's what seniors are supposed to do, lead. And by example, Devin Thomas has really brought his team back almost single-handedly. Once again, though, Duke off the bounce, getting into the paint. And you just can't say enough about the Duke offense. They've been playing some pretty good one-on-one basketball. Wake Forest unable to stop.
Will McKinn feeling the hot hand. Ingram brings it down. You call Grayson Allen the usher. He has a way of putting people in their seats when they're standing up here tonight. Guarded by Wilbekin, the step through for the sophomore. Two free throws on the way for Allen.
Well, once again, Wake Forest recognizes they got to go to the hot hand. And Devin Thomas just showing an array of offensive moves right now.
And look at the difference between what Devin Thomas has done against Duke. Played very well at home, on the road, not quite as much. And Coach K did point out, he said, I remember that game of 24 points he scored against us here last year.
Well on his way to that and then some.
13 of the last 17 Wake points have come from Devin Thomas. And now the two foul issue has reared its ugly head for Duke as Sean Obi, only the fifth transfer ever under Coach K, is on the floor. He's played 15 minutes total this year.
Really what Duke is expecting from Obi is just a good 2 minutes of solid defense. You know, no fouls.
But you gotta find number two.
Well, you gotta clog up the middle. You know, we talked about Obi being in the ball game, and you know, Sean Obi, a transfer from Rice, sat out last year, but at Rice, he averaged 11 points and 9 rebounds, so he's no stranger to solid basketball.
Obi had it, lost it. Oh, what a flush from Hudson! Wow.
Take a look here on the fast break, on the steal. And then Hudson coast to coast with a total disregard for his own safety. Save the women and children.
Look out, Grayson Allen is someone's son. And he also got the foul, his first. So a chance for Hudson to make it a 1-point game.
And right before that steal, Mike, you were making reference to the two foul issue. Mike Krzyzewski told us he recognized that, you know, when you have two fouls, normally guys sit for the remainder of the half. But he can't afford that with the thin front line particularly. These guys have to learn how to play with two fouls. We're talking about Marshall Plumlee, Derek Thornton, and Matt Jones.
The Demon Deacons on an 11-3 run. Perimeter foul, Hudson called for the bump, his first.
Got to be smart now. You can't give away opportunities on the free throw line. I mean, Duke already highly efficient offensively. They get so many shots in the paint in this particular game. You don't want to give them any free ones. 23% of their points this year have come from the free throw line, primarily because their good recognition of the other team's foul situation. When they get in the bonus and the double bonus, you won't see Duke settling for jump shots. They're going to force the issue, put it on the floor, recognizing freedom of movement is here to stay.
So Jeter is sitting, Thornton with two, Plumlee with two, Matt Jones also with two, and Allen, who's 87% at the line, knocks them both down. 19 fouls against Wake, eight against Wake and 9 against Duke.
Under 10 seconds, you got to put it on the floor. You got to penetrate. You got to make something happen.
Miller McIntyre goes baseline, 3 to shoot. Here it comes. Look at this. An offensive rebound for Thomas.
Devin Thomas just demonstrated how you offensive rebound. You got to be in perpetual motion, and you got to have desire to go get it. And on that play, he pretty much embodied both. Take a look. He's standing under the basket. He gets his body in good position on Obi, and there's nothing Obi can do but foul.
And Len, right now, Wake Forest is obliterating Duke when it comes to offensive rebounds. 10 offensive rebounds for the Demon Deacons to just 1 for the Blue Devils.
Now remember, Duke is shooting 61% from the field, so there aren't a whole lot of offensive rebounds to get. But nevertheless, you know, Wake Forest is trying to make up the points by getting to that offensive glass. And they call that one off, violation, lane violation.
On Cody Miller McIntyre.
Again, giving away points.
Thornton back on the floor with those two fouls. Spins it with the left. Oh, that's a beautiful touch.
That's just too easy, again, for a team like Wake Forest to give up a shot like that with nobody in front of Thornton.
Miller McIntyre gets the buck, and he's going to the line. 25.9 seconds remain in the first half. Duke has led by as many as 12.
You give Thornton a lot of credit. He just beats everybody down. No one stops the ball. That's the first rule in transition. Get in front of the ball. Make it veer east-west. Don't allow him to go north-south.
Not a lot of chances at the line so far this year for Miller McIntyre. But now 5 out of 7 after hitting the first. Thomas off the floor with one foul. Manning doesn't want him to get a second. Unlikely the final possession of his first 20 minutes.
Right now, Wake Forest just trying to keep Duke out of the paint, but they just can't seem to do it. That should have been a foul right there.
Jones didn't get the call, and that's how the first half comes to a close.
Look at him, his ability to get in the paint as well. Pretty much unstoppable.
So you know it's a game where the offenses have come to play when the lowest shooting percentage is 55%, and that's what Wake Forest has. They've done a great job on the offensive glass as well. 20 rebounds, 10 of those have been off of their own misses.
Well, here in the second half, I mean, Wake needs to do a better job of keeping Duke out of the paint. 12 of Duke's 18 field goals have been inside the paint.
And an open look at the lane. Devin Thomas follows it up. Game's high score with 19.
And if you're Duke, you better do something with that guy, because he's single-handedly keeping his team in the game.
They have yet to find the answer for him. On the other end, worked into some foul trouble for the Blue Devils. Ingram, Thornton, Plumlee, and Jones all ended the first half with two fouls for a team that can comfortably play 6 and maybe 7. Wilbekin has it rattle around and out.
Yeah, see, I'm not sure, you know, what you're thinking if you're Wake Forest. You got a guy that is totally destroying the other team. You take a look, a nice move by Plumlee with the ball fake, getting into the paint and gets fouled. You got a guy that's single-handedly taking the opposition apart, and you should keep going at him regardless. At least try to get it to the point where he can do just that.
Plumlee at the line, hits the first. He shoots 53% from the free throw line, and that was foul number 3 there on Dinos Mitoglou, the sophomore for Wake Forest.
Wake Forest, a little foul trouble of their own, as Mitoglou, very key component to the Wake Forest frontline attack.
First half numbers, Wake Forest, the 50 was the most they've allowed in the first half this year, and the 47 allowed by Duke tied for the most they've allowed in a first half. 47 against Georgetown as well. Mitoglou, tremendous three-point shooter. Off the mark there, controlled by Jones for Duke.
And once again, judgment. Wake doesn't get any paint touches on that particular possession. That's what's giving Duke problems, the paint touches as well as getting the ball to Devin Thomas, and two times in a row they forget he's on the floor.
Thomas went for the steal, and Plumlee ends up at the bucket, and that's a foul.
Well, you can see Duke's strategy right now. Devin Thomas is killing them on the on Wake's offensive end, so let's make him work on the defensive end. And here Plumlee giving Thomas a little bit of his own medicine, putting it on the floor and going straight at the basket.
You watch Mitoglou's body language, and it didn't particularly look like he thought Plumlee was going to take that drive all the way. So a technical foul has been assessed to Devin Thomas. And they put Grayson Allen at the line, an 87% shooter.
And if there's any criticism of Devin Thomas, sometimes his motor gets out of whack. He gets a little wound up a little too tightly, and in a critical time like this is not the time to get a technical foul. Got to keep your emotions in check.
He goes to the bench now, three personal fouls. And that's a big blow for Wake Forest. Not 2 minutes into the second half, Thomas with 19 points.
Boy, the inability to keep it zipped has really cost his team. Not only is he not on the floor and they are able to get points, but with the three fouls, I mean, that's severely limiting his ability to do anything else for the next several minutes.
Beyond his scoring, the highest scorer for Wake Forest is Cody Miller-McIntyre with 10. And then Mitoglou with 7. It's a 6-0 Blue Devils run right now.
And if you're a Wake Forest fan, just when you think we were getting within striking distance, keeping it close enough, all of a sudden Duke creates some distance, helped by the technical foul.
Miller-McIntyre couldn't get it. It's a foul on the way up. The freshman Collins to shoot two for the Demon Deacons. Foul is on Grayson Allen, the second for the Duke sophomore.
And that time Wake Forest got back to the fundamentals, and that was trying to get the ball inside, get some paint touches. Danny Manning emphasized that in his talk with us today. And that's what his team certainly wants to try to do. The more paint touches they get, the more efficient he thinks they become.
Especially for a guy like Collins, the freshman from West Palm Beach, Florida, who gets 1 of 2, who says he was expected to be ready. Him and Brian Crawford expected them to get on the floor and score right away. A little bit of the opposite for Duke, but their freshmen have been thrust into primetime roles. Wide open underneath, a pump fake, and a finish for Plumlee.
There's a little bit of inexperience by the Wake Forest freshman. You know, they totally lose their man.
Plumlee turns it away, averaging 2 blocks a game this year.
And Marshall Plumlee's become a force on the offensive end as well. Take a look on the screen and then on the roll. Everybody just forgets, as I mentioned. You know, you have a guy like Brian Crawford who was down low, totally forget that Plumlee's in the paint, and he steps outside on the wing, leaving the big fella by himself.
You saw Hudson there pointing for Collins to get back as well. That's a big difference, too. We look at Devin Thomas and the 19 points that he scored today, but he provides an interior presence and you'd imagine a vocal presence as well for his teammates to help them figure out where to go.
Yeah, he's the experienced senior. He's seen it. And that time, on that last possession, the two freshmen were the ones victimized.
Derek Thornton is safe at third on the slide and lost it. The officials say out of bounds off of Wake Forest.
Trying to turn on the Jets, a change of speed. And obviously, somebody needs to go in and wipe up that perspiration. Here they come.
The ball off the chest of Collins.
Coming in for the Deacons, number 23, Rondell Watson. He replaces Brian Crawford.
Rondell Watson is in replacing Brian Crawford. Crawford going to the bench scoreless thus far. Allen's try, short. Plumlee the offensive rebound. Jones steps into a three.
And I know they're trained when you get the offensive rebound to kick it back outside because everybody is stuffed in the middle off the shot. But Plumlee had an opportunity to go to the basket on that one. Good offensive rebound.
Collins got it. Oh, it falls off the rim.
That did everything but go in. And that's a shame, man. Excellent effort. And you got nothing to show for it.
6-point lead for the Blue Devils. A drop off for Plumlee. And Collins pokes it away.
And once again, Plumlee behind the basket. The defenders are looking at the ball, and he sneaks behind the defense only to get the delivery. He lost it that time, but he's been pretty effective with that.
Wilbekin, it's going the other way. The foul is on Matt Jones, the push-off, and that's his fourth personal foul.
Well, apparently, Mike Krzyzewski not very happy with that call. Take a look at the drive here. That's too close to call. I mean, Mike might have an argument there.
9 times out of 10, that's probably on Wilbekin.
Yep.
So Jones is replaced by Kennard, the freshman. Wake Forest, 0 for its last 6 from the floor. Helped out with a foul there. And that's on Allen, his third personal. So number 14, Duke, hurt by injury. Emile Jefferson out indefinitely, has missed now 6 games, including this one, with that foot injury. And it's a rotation of essentially 6 and sometimes 7 players.
We saw in the first half where Devin Thomas was able to take over. And here in the second half, it's got to be Cody Miller-McIntyre, the senior, out there on the floor.
Fourth foul on Grayson Allen.
Well, I'm not sure Allen had legal guarding position, and the contact was made. The arm wasn't extended, so they can't call an offensive player for the push-off.
Allen's on the floor for now. Chase Jeter will come in at the next dead ball. Cody Miller-McIntyre, a season high, 12 points.
And that's what I said. This half has to be his half. He's got to be the orchestrator, the maestro, as well as the scorer.
A timeout at the Joel. The winner will try and bring Alabama to a college football playoff championship. And a tremendous year for him and Nick Saban's squad. Mike Cousins, Len Elmore with you here at the Joel in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Number 14, Duke, up by 4, and 4 is not a good number. Grayson Allen, Matt Jones, 2 pivotal players, each with 4 fouls in a shortened rotation. It's another timeout. The foul there on Mitchell Wilbekin, his second for the Demon Deacons.
He's just getting more and more time, and his team is now depending on him as he's come into a feature role. But after that championship game where he literally brought Duke back from the brink with his stellar play offensively, you knew he had it in him, and he's just carried it over this year.
Kennard fights off contact into the corner and turns it into 2 points. The lead is back to 6 for Duke. Number 14 team in the country, only losses against Kentucky and Utah. Tradition conference play on the road since Emile Jefferson went down is arguably their toughest test.
And you see the zone defense, Duke is forced to play. I'm not sure Mike Krzyzewski is in love with the 2-3, but he knows he has to go to it because of the foul trouble. And it seems to be paying dividends.
Now Jeter rising. Rejected. Wake Forest still on defense.
You know what it's able to do, one, the zone kind of throws Wake Forest off balance a little bit offensively, as you see Devin Thomas back in the ball game, and he's got to be very, very careful with those 3 fouls. But it also allows Duke to play the 2 bigs Plumlee and Jeter, and giving them better board coverage.
Thomas back on the floor, 19 points. He's 8 of 10 shooting. Perhaps they can engage some high-low as Collins. Oh, what a finish!
Oh, and we forgot Devin Thomas can pass the ball, as Collins demonstrated all of his athleticism.
Now Kennard goes off the window. Another rebound for Thomas. A double-double for him tonight. His 8th of the season and the 29th of his career.
Well, let's take a look right here. High-low situation. Thomas gets surrounded by three guys, and he doesn't let any grass grow under his feet when it comes to getting rid of that ball. As soon as the triple team came, he caught a streaking Collins on the baseline.
Three-point try doesn't go, and it's Wake Forest basketball. Len, that last possession there, Thomas looked low, didn't have it, didn't have a shot himself and passed out. He does what you say has disappeared from the big man game, is turn and face in the high post.
Yeah, I mean, against the zone, so many guys just catch it facing out front and never really look down low to see what's available. They don't do their checkoffs, and it's so easy for zones to play them. As you saw a score right there by Wake Forest, bring him within two. And I talked about the zone kind of getting Wake off balance a little bit. Well, they've gotten their sea legs, and they're starting to pick that zone apart.
Oh, my goodness. A stunning reversal of possession there. Mike Krzyzewski can't believe it, because the call was that it was off of Luke Kennard. Roger Ayers, the official, made the call, and Wake Forest has a chance to tie or take the lead.
Important right now for Duke to maintain their poise. You got three freshmen out there, four freshmen out there. Good call.
To charge on Miller McIntyre, his first.
Take a look right here. Kennard does. Yeah, it did. It bounced on the line, and Kennard kicked it. It hit the end line. So it's a good call by the officials.
The Hawkeyes of Roger Ayers there. Still a two-point game. Thornton with the runner. No. And Collins snatches it up. What a game he's having.
And like I said, the freshmen have to maintain their poise. Wow. Way off.
Watson missed it all.
Talk about the baptism of fire here in a conference game. Mike Krzyzewski playing four freshmen in a critical part of the ball game.
Shot clock where it has rarely been. Under 10 for Duke. Contested pull-up. No. Plumlee the offensive rebound, and a fresh 30 seconds for the Blue Devils.
Wow, great hustle by Marshall Plumlee. Once that shot went up, he got position. He
scores,
and that full extension just went right past the defender. Those long arms, my goodness, what an advantage.
First points for the freshman since the 5.5 minute mark of the first half. A lob to the backside, nicely defended by Plumlee. Wake Forest will have possession when we come back.
Well, we talked about Duke having to rely on the freshman, and they're led by Brandon Ingram. Look at the length, the poise, the accuracy. That man's good.
Cousins, Len Elmore, and let's pretend we're on the Price is Right and play the high-low game here.
Yeah, I mean, against a 2-3 zone, you take a look right here in a high-low situation. Devin Thomas is up right there, and you see the attention that he receives. And once he gets the ball inside, you take a look right here. He gets four guys, one, two, three, 4, you get the cutter here, and obviously Chase Jeter should be in the middle, but he's too far off the lane, and Thomas does a great job of drawing the attention and delivering the ball on time.
It lined up nicely for Hudson on the inbounds, but didn't drop. So Duke holds on to its 4-point lead. They've led by as many as 12 in this one on the road. And the Blue Devils have taken 9 of the last 10 from the Demon Deacons. Foul on the drive by Ingram.
And it's surprising me right now. Ingram, obviously an outstanding player, but he's continually going to his right. And once he puts the ball on the floor and he goes to his right, creates a lot of problems as Wake Forest has to step up and help. And they haven't been able to keep him out of the paint yet.
Off on the first for the native of Kinston, North Carolina. Same hometown as Jerry Stackhouse, who helped coach him in AAU. There's Allen Jones, sideline with the 4 fouls. Tattoo on his shoulder says, "Small city, big dreams." Good feature by C.L. Brown today on ESPN.com. Talk about Ingram and where he came from. Look at the defense. They're sagging in on Collins as he drops in. And the foul is on Jeter, his first.
Yeah, Jeter trying to take the position away from Collins inside. And once again, freedom of movement is getting enforced very tightly.
Now, what does this tell you here? That Jeter with 1 foul sits for Jones, who's got 4.
Oh, what a block.
Ingram comes in to stuff it.
Looked like a good play and an outstanding play set up, but even better defense by Ingram.
They had a mismatch on the ball screen. It's swatted by Plumlee and recovered by Thornton. A kick out. Ingram a 3. Now Miller McIntyre has it taken away, and Kennard gets the bucket.
You got to wait for the traffic to clear. And Wake Forest careless with the ball, and it's costing him.
The freshman Crawford, who got a lot of experience with Miller McIntyre injured, who lost it. To the wing, Hudson, yes, from 3.
Danny Manning told us he's going to live with the mistakes that Brian Crawford might make as a freshman because he's given him so much. Averaging 14 points a game, doing some wonderful things out on the floor. Nice rebound there, couldn't finish.
And this time, what do you have? A senior who waits for the traffic to clear, brings it down the floor, and scores!
Man, oh man, oh man. Devin Thomas just showing off.
A timeout for Duke. Blue Devils up by 2.
Well, Luke Kennard did an outstanding job offensive rebounding. And then on the steal, does a nice job of finishing. And here on the other side, good find by Miller McIntyre. And finally, the exclamation point on that last possession. Devin Thomas pushes the ball up the floor and scores with nobody impeding his way to the basket. But just, again, showing off the talents of a guy who's having a player of the year quality season so far.
Back-to-back seasons where here at the Joel, Devin Thomas has had a great game against Duke, 24 a year ago, 21 tonight. Ingram.
Oh.
And it's swatted by Collins. At midcourt, Kennard touched it last.
Where did he come from? John Collins had it lined up. Look at him on the left side of the screen. Had it lined up all the way. Ball on the way up. And the best part about that, he hit it off the glass, kept it in play so his teammates can get possession instead of swatting it out of bounds.
Oh. Looking for the high-low. Too far out of the reach of Collins. That's a tough one. Plumlee was sitting back waiting for it along with the rest of the interior defense.
Well, Devin Thomas, too unselfish on that one. Plumlee was back so far. Thomas had an easy shot from the free throw line. Those are the ones you got to take. You got to keep the defense honest. Every time Wake gets a little close, they kind of self-destruct a little bit, and Duke takes full advantage of the mistakes.
Quiet day for Thornton so far, averaging 10. Now has 7 tonight to bring the lead back to 4. Miller McIntyre, the season high 12 for him tonight. Passed Crawford out of a shot, 9 to shoot. And a fadeaway from the freshman. Off the rim, who touched it last? Blue Devils basketball. Now a substitution as well for Duke, as Grayson Allen replaces Matt Jones. 1-4 foul player for another.
Grayson Allen with those 4 fouls. Mike Krzyzewski kind of rolling the dice a little bit, hopeful that Grayson Allen, just a sophomore, understands how to play with 4 fouls. He can still get effectiveness out of him.
Kennard, and it's a bump on the floor.
Tell you what, you got to move your feet. That's 4 on Devin Thomas, and that's 1 that I guarantee you he wishes he had back. Take a look right there. He gets that left arm impeding Kennard going to the basket. And once again, you give Duke a great deal of credit. They recognize the team foul situation. They're not going to settle for jump shots. That was kind of a mismatch with Kennard being guarded by the big fella Thomas. And he took it to the basket, hopeful that Thomas would use his hands and foul.
One of the drills that is done in practice every day for Wake Forest is to have players do a shell drill, defensive slides, holding a towel in both hands so they can't reach. They've got to play with their feet. But like you said, a mismatch there for the much quicker Kennard.
Where's that towel when you need it if you're Wake Forest?
High-low with Mitoglou for Collins. Plumlee stayed straight up. The freshman Collins on his second try gets the foul. Free throws may be the story down the stretch.
When we launched the new Wendy's 4-for-4 meal, people really thought it was a big deal with the junior bacon.
Before putting Grayson Allen in, and obviously it's a little bit different playing in the front line as opposed to playing in the backcourt. It's harder to hide when you're playing up front, and I think that's the dilemma Danny Manning had. So he'll probably try to hold on and see if his team can stay within striking distance, maybe till about 4 minutes left in this game. But if they get behind 8 or 10 points, he's going to have to insert Devin Thomas and hope for the best.
0-for-2 there for Collins.
Wow.
Free throws hurt them against Louisville, and now playing a difference tonight as well.
Combine the missed free throw opportunities with some of the more critical, untimely mistakes. And, you know, Wake Forest has had opportunities right now. Not going to get very many more. As you saw Ingram get the ball slapped out of his hands.
And how well does Wake Forest defend the interior here? You've got the freshman Collins matched up with Plumlee, who's scored in a lot of drop-offs. He's got 10.
Collins playing tag with him right now, recognizing where he is, but he's got to be able to resist trying to help out. Because once he commits, Duke very adept at dropping it off. There's no rotation on the weak side. Take a look right here on the drive. Now Collins steps up. And unfortunately, Bryant Crawford, once again, too late on the rotation. You got to get down there quickly. Force the pass to go back outside. He had an opportunity to intercept that pass had he anticipated the rotation.
The 6-0 Duke run. It was a delay of game whistle against Plumlee, who swatted the ball out of bounds after the dunk. Lob to the backside. Collins can't get it. Helps to have a 7-footer there for Duke. Plumlee may well be the most important player on the floor tonight for the Blue Devils. Kennard. And it's two touchdowns for Plumlee. 14 for the graduate student.
And that's his high this season. Had 12 against Kentucky. But once again, in the right place at the right time.
Crawford was there to clean it up and got caught in a bunch of tangled arms. A foul ensues. Second on Kennard.
Yeah, we mentioned it in the first half. This has happened time and time again. Plumlee on that baseline behind the basket, awaiting the penetration by his teammates. And when his man goes to help on the penetration, he's had his hands kept full.
Crawford against Louisville on Sunday, a game they lost 65-57, was 0-5 at the line, and can now clear that specter from the back of his brain. He was getting some good-natured ribbing from assistant Randolph Childress the last couple days about that. I'll tell you what, the guy with the most one-liners in the gym is Randolph Childress. He's got something for everybody.
Yeah, I've known him for a long, long time. He's got that wry sense of humor. Kind of had a sense of humor as a player, too. And he filling up buckets, and opponents didn't think it was so funny. As the drive, once again, not settling. And Danny Manning still thinks his team's within striking distance. He's keeping Thomas on the bench.
And Plumlee was glued to Collins, which left the lane wide open for Miller McIntyre.
And if I take a look at the numbers right now, and I'm Wake Forest, I pack it in, try to take the drive away from Duke and maybe force them to take the three. They were 5 of 10 at half. They've been 0 of 5 here in the second half.
Allen takes the drive and gets the foul. 5:24 to play. Allen on the floor with those four fouls. The foul is on Collins, the third, on the Wake Forest freshman big man who's played a very big part today, and especially now with Thomas seated with four fouls.
And once again, the Blue Devils have been relentless at putting it on the floor and driving, getting into the lane in the heart of the Wake Forest defense, which has created so many issues, whether it's fouls, whether it's penetration and slow rotation leading to easy Duke layups. They've really put the pressure on the Wake Forest defense.
The 2 points there for Allen are his first in nearly 12 minutes of game action. Wake Forest ball, 21 on the shot clock.
Another block for Plumlee right now. Came into this game averaging almost 2 blocks per game.
Beautiful lob for Miller McIntyre. A nice set there from Danny Manning. 75-68.
And if you're Wake, you got to take a stand right now. You got to keep Duke out of the paint. As I said, you back off and force them to shoot the threes. It looked like nobody was willing for Duke, willing to pull up and take a shot. They keep taking it to the hole.
ESPN with two big college hoop games for you Saturday, 1 Eastern. It's in the Big Ten. Number 3, Maryland and Mello Trimble against Wisconsin. And then at 8, Jim Boeheim returns from his hiatus, looking for Syracuse's first ACC win of the year against high-flying North Carolina, part of a journey to the tourney matchup. Both games streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Foul number 4 there on Dinos Mitoglou for Wake Forest. So he sits, Rondale Watson back on the floor. Still no Devin Thomas, so it looks like it'll be this final 4-minute stretch of the game where Thomas comes back onto the floor and tries to make it a comeback for the Demon Deacons.
And once again, Duke reaping the benefits of being aggressive going to the basket. Got a ton of points from the free throw line.
There's a mismatch. Miller McIntyre, 16 points.
Wake Forest trying to play on the same page with Duke as far as taking it to the basket. But again, for Wake to be able to come back, they have got to be able to seal off that middle. Back off the shooters and force them maybe to take some jump shots. Oh, that's a travel.
Allen got away with a walk. He got caught in between where he was going to go with it. And Kennard is the beneficiary, plus a foul.
He's a lefty. And I guess everybody in the gym knows it except the guy who's guarding him. Once again, on the drive, take a look at Allen right here. 1-2. He got away with steps right there. But when you close out, you saw the defender close out on Kennard's right hand. He's a lefty. Close on the left hand. But that's where lefties have that advantage. Because muscle memory, your first reaction, because you're guarding so many righties, is the close on the right.
Miller McIntyre with the response for the Demon Deacons.
Take a look at the drive here. Pretty much the same thing. No help as Plumlee really staying close to John Collins. And I think as long as Wake Forest is, you know, maintaining, you know, at least some closeness to Duke at this point in time, Danny Manning can hold off with Devin Thomas, but it's getting close to Devin Thomas time. I think if Duke scores here, you can see the big fella get up off the bench. It's time for Danny Manning to kind of roll the dice. Up, oh, he's up now.
Under 4 minutes. There has been no answer for Plumlee unless Thomas has been on the floor.
And part of the reason is Thomas, even though he defies definition as far as a position, is accustomed to playing the five spot, which gives help in the middle, last line of defense. Out there, you don't have anybody really that has the experience of playing the five. Collins is about as close as you get. But once again, we talked about experience in guarding the basket.
A big three-pointer for Grayson Allen. And it's the largest lead of the night for Duke. Hudson comes right back and negates the triple. Now inside of 3 minutes to play in Winston-Salem. Ten on the shot clock.
Now see, they're taking, trying to take Allen's right hand away from him.
And the Blue Devils will have four to shoot as Devin Thomas tries to play savior with 21 points for Wake Forest.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball.
Huge tonight with 16 for Duke.
He's been perfect from the field. And usually when you're shooting point blank, off of the penetration and the find, it's hard to miss. Plumlee 6 of 6 on the field, 4 of 4 from the free throw line. And he's gone to the basket strong. His teammates have helped him an awful lot. His movement and him making himself available has really given Duke a lift.
16 is a new career high. And as the shot clock expires, it's Kennard with two more, 87-75. Wake Forest has got to score and do it quickly.
And on Kennard's shot, he was guarded off a switch by Devin Thomas, who can't do much of anything with four fouls.
Plumlee just keeps it going, ho-hum. His seventh rebound of the night after a miss by Wilbekin.
You know, it's amazing, beginning of the game and in talking to the coaches, particularly to Mike Krzyzewski, the worry was obviously Devin Thomas being able to get his guys in foul trouble. And certainly he has, but it's really been Marshall Plumlee who has gotten Devin Thomas in foul trouble per se. And is really taking advantage of him now down the stretch
as well as throughout the game. Right now, he is 7-for-7 from the field. Plumlee.
And takes a seat here with a minute 28 to go. What a game for Plumlee, a career high 18 to go along with 7 rebounds, and it's a timeout for Wake Forest. You look back to that last game Saturday against Boston College, an 81-64 win. You had Ingram, Plumlee, Allen, and Jones all playing at least 34 minutes. They went a little deeper on the bench tonight with Sean Obi getting a few.
Could provide an obstacle for Duke, again, with the short bench and playing, you know, a lot of young players playing on the road. It's tough, but right now they have done more than survived here at Wake Forest. They've dominated.
Texas Tech, Iowa State, number 13 team in the country. To follow, as Brendan told you moments ago, Texas Tech has rattled off 11 straight wins, including a victory over Texas over the weekend. Here inside to Joel. Duke 13-11 all time in this series. Last year, the Blue Devils took both. Final score here last year was 73-65 when Devin Thomas had 24 points. Tonight, Thomas with 21. But it appears now with a minute 15 to play, that will not be enough for Wake Forest, looking for its first ACC win of the year.
Yeah, we talked about the young players that Duke has had to rely on, and that's played out to a certain extent. You know, Brandon Ingram with 17, Luke Kennard with 19. But it's really the two veterans, and I would call Grayson Allen a veteran, even though he's a sophomore, and this is the first year that he's really been a starter. Allen with 24, and Marshall Plumlee has been outstanding, you know, with 18 points, 7-of-7 from the field. And sometimes it takes a senior to step up and lead.
And that senior number 2 in the old goal did that today for Wake Forest, but now has fouled out with 21 points. His 8th double-double of the year.
Yeah, when Devin Thomas wasn't in foul trouble, he was busy keeping his team in the game, making aggressive moves to the basket. You know, demonstrating again his ability to handle the ball, quick first step to the basket, you know, nifty moves underneath. But the foul situation caught up to him, and again, a couple of silly fouls that I'm sure he wishes he had back, as does Wake Forest. You know, once he went out, that changed the whole tenor of the game. And Duke was able to really step forward and, as I said, really dominate the paint with Marshall Plumlee showing the way.
Kennard now with 23, one shy of his career high, which is 24 against Utah earlier this season. I'll tell you what a big difference maker has been in this game as well, is the way that Duke has shot the ball at the free throw line. 25 of 27. Meanwhile, Wake Forest 12 of 20 with those same opportunities. So now inside of 25 seconds, a couple times to close out the non-conference slate. Duke surpassed 100. Right now, 91-75. Three-pointer from Jones doesn't go. The Blue Devils with a win go to 13-2, 2-0 in the ACC. Second time under Coach K that they've opened with back-to-back road wins in the league. Wake Forest now 9-5 and 0-2 in ACC play. The final 91-75. Coming up next, college hoops with Texas Tech and number 13 Iowa State. So for our crew, Len Elmore, I'm Mike Cousins. Thanks for watching. Now back to the studio with Dino Gaudio. Here's Brendan Fitzgerald.